Welcome students once again into the class of number theory, and in this video we will discuss about Jacobi symbol. In previous videos we have seen what is Legendre symbol and what are the properties of Legendre symbol, and now we are moving on to the next topic, that is Jacobi symbol. So let us first see what is Jacobi symbol and how it is being denoted. So let Q be an odd positive integer, and let P be any integer, capital P be any integer, such that GCD of P and Q is 1. That means P and Q are coprime. Let Q can be factorized as Q1, Q2, Q3, and so on, Qk. Definitely, Q is odd, so all the factors of Q will also be odd. So let Q can be factorized like this. Then Jacobi's symbol is denoted and defined as. The notation for Jacobi symbol is same as that of the Legendre symbol. We denote it by the same round brackets P by Q, but usually we use capital letters in Jacobi symbol and small English alphabets for Legendre symbol. So P upon Q, capital P upon capital Q is Jacobi symbol, which is equal to, if you put down the value of Q here, which is factorized value, Q1, Q2, Qk, then this Jacobi symbol is defined as the product of Legendre symbols P upon Q1, P upon Q2, and so on, P upon Qk. Here, each one of these is a Legendre symbol. Actually, Q is an odd positive integer, whereas Qi's, Q1, Q2, Qk, these are odd prime integers. And if you are having a denominator odd prime integer, then definitely it will be a Legendre symbol. So that is the definition of Jacobi symbol. In Jacobi symbol, the denominator need not be prime, whereas in Legendre symbol, the denominator is a prime number. So what we have done, the denominator, which is just an odd positive integer, we have broken it into several odd prime integers, and then we separated it into the Legendre symbol. So this is the definition of Jacobi symbol. And let us have one example, and then we will move ahead. Suppose I'm taking Q as 105, and P is an integer, so take P as 8. So what is your Jacobi symbol is 8 upon 105. This denominator, you can break it in odd prime integers as a product. So you can write it as 3 into 5 into 7. And now it can be broken into the Legendre symbols. 8 upon 3, 8 by 5, and 8 by 7. Here 105 was not a prime, but in each of these the denominator is a prime. Now we have to solve it. How to solve it? First of all, the numerator is greater than the denominator you are seeing here. Whenever the numerator is greater than denominator, what we have to do? We have to replace that numerator by the remainder obtained by dividing numerator by denominator. So 8 divided by 3, you will get 2 here as remainder. 8 divided by 5, you will get 3 here as remainder, and here you will get the remainder 1. 1 upon P, Legendre symbol, we know that it is equal to 1. So this is 1, multiplication with 1 make no sense, it will give the same number. Now 2 by 3 and 3 by 5.
So 2 by 3 is 2 upon P. 2 upon P, and this P is congruent to 3 modulo 8. So the value of this part is minus 1 into this is 3 upon 5. Use here the quadratic reciprocity law. So what you are going to get? 5 upon 3 and no negative sign, because one of these numbers, especially this 5, you can see this 5 is congruent to 1 modulo 4. If one of the numbers is congruent to 1 modulo 4, the value becomes in reverse in Legendre symbol and the sign remains the same. Now once again it is minus, and this 5 by 3 you can once again replace the numerator by the remainder obtained on dividing this 5 by 3, and it will be 2. So 2 by 3, you divide 5 by 3 and remainder obtained will be 2. 2 by 3, once again we have seen that 2 by 3 value is minus 1. So it is minus of minus 1 means 1. So the value of this Jacobi symbol is equal to 1. This is just an example to understand the difference between Jacobi symbol and Legendre symbol. Now we are moving on to some properties of Jacobi symbol, as we have seen in the previous videos about Legendre symbol. So you can say, you can call it a theorem. You can call it a theorem. Let P dash be any integers, Q dash be odd positive integers, such that the GCD of P dash and Q dash is equal to 1. Then we have several properties. We will write one by one and we will prove them one by one. So the first one is that P upon Q dash is equal to P upon Q multiplied by P upon Q dash. And how to prove it? So let your Q be Q1, Q2 and so on, Qm, and let your Q dash be Q1 dash, Q2 dash and so on, Qn dash. If this is Q, this is Q dash, what is your Q dash? It is Q1, Q2 and so on, Qm, and then continued Q1 dash, Q2 dash and so on, Qn dash. Now start with this left hand side. Your left hand side is P upon Q dash. Substitute the value of Q dash. Your Q dash is here. It is Q1, Q2, Qm, Q1 dash, Q2 dash, Qn dash. This is a Jacobi symbol. And according to the definition of Jacobi symbol, it can be broken into the products of Legendre symbols. So what the Legendre symbols will be? P upon Q1, P upon Q2 and so on, P upon Qm into P upon Q1 dash into P upon Q2 dash into and so on, P upon Qn dash. Now look at this portion. Look at this portion. Once again, from these Legendre symbols, since the numerator is same, you can convert it into the Jacobi symbol. And when you will convert it into the Jacobi symbol, you will get P upon Q1, Q2, Qm. Similarly, the second portion can also be assembled once again into Jacobi symbol to get P upon Q1 dash, Q2 dash and so on, Q1 dash. Now this Q1 into Q2 into Qm, the value is equal to Q. So replace this product by Q. Similarly, in the second part, this Q1 dash, Q2 dash, Qn dash is equal to Q dash. So replace this part by capital Q dash. So what we have now, the right hand side, that is P upon Q and P upon Q dash, the Jacobi symbols product. So P upon Q dash is equal to P upon Q, P upon Q dash is the first property of Jacobi symbols. Now Let us see what is the second property. The second property regarding Jacobi's symbol says that PP dash upon Q is also can also be broken as P upon Q into P dash upon Q. And the proof is once again very easy. Let your Q be Q1, Q2 and so on Qs. Substitute in the left hand side. Your left hand side is the Jacobi symbol PP dash upon Q1, Q2, Qs. What I have done? I have substituted the value of Q here. Now use the definition of Jacobi symbol so it can be broken into S Legendre symbols. So what these Legendre symbols will be? PP dash upon Q1 into PP dash upon Q2 into and so on PP dash upon Qs, and each one of these is now a Legendre symbol. And in Legendre symbols we know that PP dash upon Q1 is P upon Q1, P dash upon Q1. This is the property of now Legendre symbol. So by properties of Legendre symbol, it is broken as P upon Q1, P dash upon Q1. Similarly, the second one can be broken as P upon Q2, P dash upon Q2, and so on. The last one can be broken as P upon Qs, P dash upon Qs. Now look at, compile these, the first one, the second one, sorry, the third one, the fifth one, and so on, the second last. P upon Q1, P upon Q2, P upon Qs. And once again, assemble these to get the Jacobi symbol, which is now P upon Q1, Q2, Q3, and so on, Qs. Q1, Q2, and Qs. This is the Jacobi symbol now. Earlier, these were Legendre symbols, and now it is Jacobi symbol. And similarly, the rest of the portions, the second one, the fourth one, the sixth one, and the last one, you can write it, you can assemble it to get the Jacobi symbol P dash upon Q1, Q2, and so on, Qs. So what is Q1, Q2, Qs? It is given to be equal to Q. So you get P upon Q, Jacobi symbol, into P dash upon Q, Jacobi symbol. So PP dash Q can also be broken as P upon Q, P dash upon Q in Jacobi symbols. So this is the second property, and still more properties are there. So let us see what the rest of the properties are. We will prove them one by one to get proper knowledge about the Jacobi symbols. The third one property says that P square upon Q Jacobi symbol is equal to 1. So look at how. Your left hand side is now P square upon Q. Left hand side is now P square upon Q. We can write it as P upon Q. Just now we have proved that PP dash upon Q is P upon Q, P dash upon Q. So it can also be written as P upon Q into P upon Q. So it is P upon Q Jacobi symbol square. And since the value of Jacobi symbol is either 1 or minus 1, so plus minus 1 square is equal to 1. Similarly, another property says that P upon Q square is 1. And that is also similar proof. P upon Q square. Once again, just now we have shown that P upon Q, Q dash is P upon Q into P upon Q dash. So write it Q square as Q into Q, and it will become P upon Q Jacobi symbol into P upon Q Jacobi symbol, and once again it is P upon Q square. And we know that P upon Q Jacobi symbol is either 1 or minus 1. In either case, the square will be equal to 1. So P upon Q square is 1, P square upon Q is also 1. So it is another interesting property of Jacobi symbols. And then there are more properties. One property I am writing here, the fourth property, you can say that P dash P square upon Q dash Q square is equal to P dash upon Q क्यू डैश. सो इट इज अनदर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस प्रॉपर्टीज वी हैव प्रूव्ड. सो स्टार्ट विद द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, पी डैश पी स्क्वायर अपॉन क्यू डैश क्यू स्क्वायर. यूजिंग द अर्लियर प्रॉपर्टीज वी हैव प्रूव्ड, इट कैन बी रिटन एज पी डैश पी स्क्वायर अपॉन क्यू डैश सॉरी अपॉन क्यू डैश इनटू पी डैश पी स्क्वायर अपॉन क्यू स्क्वायर. वी हैव ब्रोकन फ्रॉम द डेनोमिनेटर एंड नाउ द न्यूमरेटर कैन ऑल्सो बी ब्रोकन. सो यू कैन राइट इट एज पी डैश अपॉन क्यू डैश इंटू पी स्क्वायर अपॉन क्यू डैश इंटू पी डैश अपॉन क्यू स्क्वायर इंटू पी स्क्वायर अपॉन क्यू स्क्वायर. यूजिंग अर्लियर प्रॉपर्टीज, दिस इज वन, दिस इज वन, दिस इज ऑल्सो वन. सो पी डैश अपॉन क्यू डैश इंटू वन इंटू वन इंटू वन इज इक्वल टू पी डैश अपॉन क्यू डैश. सो पी डैश पी स्क्वायर अपॉन क्यू स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू पी डैश अपॉन क्यू डैश इन जैकोबी सिंबल्स. सो इट इज अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग प्रॉपर्टी. एंड लेट अस मूव ऑन टू अनदर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ जैकोबी सिंबल्स. सो इट सेज दैट द फिफ्थ वन, पी डैश इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू पी मॉड्यूलो क्यू इंप्लाइज दैट पी अपॉन क्यू लिगैंडर जैकोबी सिंबल इज सेम एज पी डैश अपॉन क्यू जैकोबी सिंबल. दिस इज गिवन, पी डैश इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू पी मॉड्यूलो क्यू. लेट योर क्यू बी क्यू वन क्यू टू एंड सो ऑन क्यू एस. नाउ पी डैश इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू पी मॉड्यूलो क्यू मीन्स योर क्यू डिवाइड्स पी डैश माइनस पी. एंड सिंस क्यू वन क्यू टू क्यू एस आर फैक्टर्स ऑफ एस, सो ईच ऑफ क्यू जे विल डिवाइड क्यू. क्यू जे डिवाइड्स क्यू एंड क्यू डिवाइड्स दिस मीन्स ईच ऑफ द क्यू जे विल डिवाइड पी डैश माइनस पी. सो दैट मीन्स पी डैश इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू पी मॉड्यूलो क्यू जे फॉर एवरी जे इज इक्वल टू वन टू थ्री एंड सो ऑन टू एस. नाउ व्हाट इज क्यू जे? क्यू जे इज ऑड प्राइम. सो इफ क्यू जे इज ऑड प्राइम एंड ए इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी, वी नो दैट फ्रॉम द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लिगैंडर सिंबल दैट पी डैश अपॉन क्यू जे विल बिकम इक्वल टू द लिगैंडर सिंबल पी अपॉन क्यू जे. दिस इज नाउ आई हैव यूज्ड द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ लिगैंडर सिंबल्स. एंड सिंस इट इज ट्रू फॉर ऑल जे, सो देयर प्रोडक्ट विल ऑल्सो बी सेम. एंड टेकिंग प्रोडक्ट यू विल गेट पी डैश अपॉन क्यू वन क्यू टू क्यू एस इज इक्वल टू पी अपॉन क्यू वन क्यू टू एंड क्यू एस. एंड वॉट इज द प्रोडक्ट क्यू वन क्यू टू क्यू एस? इट इज नथिंग बट क्यू. सो पी डैश अपॉन क्यू इज सेम एज पी अपॉन क्यू इन जैकोबी सिंबल्स इफ पी डैश इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू पी मॉड्यूलो क्यू. सो दिस वॉज अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ जैकोबी सिंबल्स. एंड नाउ टू वेरी यूजफुल वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट दैट वी हैव प्रूव्ड इन केस ऑफ लिगैंडर सिंबल्स. नाउ वी आर प्रूविंग द सेम रिजल्ट फॉर जैकोबी सिंबल्स. वॉट दीज रिजल्ट आर? दीज रिजल्ट सेज दैट, दिस इज थ्योरम वंस अगेन, लेट क्यू बी ऑड इंटीजर पॉजिटिव इंटीजर. क्यू बी ऑड पॉजिटिव इंटीजर एंड पी बी एंड नो नीड ऑफ पी नाउ बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू प्रूव सम प्रॉपर्टी नॉट इंक्लूडिंग पी. सो लेट क्यू बी ऑड पॉजिटिव इंटीजर. देन नंबर वन, माइनस वन अपॉन क्यू जैकोबी सिंबल इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन रेज टू द पावर क्यू माइनस वन बाई टू. दैट मीन्स द प्रॉपर्टी इज सेम दैट वॉज इन केस ऑफ लिगैंडर सिंबल. सेकेंडली द जैकोबी सिंबल टू अपॉन क्यू इज ऑल्सो सेम एज इन द प्रीवियस केस, इट इज माइनस वन रेज टू द पावर क्यू स्क्वायर माइनस वन बाई ए. एंड नाउ वील प्रूव दीज टू प्रॉपर्टीज वन बाई वन. सो लेट मी स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट वन प्रॉपर्टी प्रूफ. लेट क्यू कैन बी फैक्टराइज्ड एज क्यू वन क्यू टू एंड क्यू एस. देन माइनस वन अपॉन क्यू इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन अपॉन क्यू वन क्यू टू क्यू एस. एंड यूजिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ जैकोबी सिंबल इट कैन बी रिटन एज minus 1 upon Q1, minus 1 upon Q2, and so on, minus 1 upon Qs. Now, each of these is a Legendre symbol. And for Legendre symbol, we know that minus 1 upon P is minus 1 raised to the power P minus 1 by 2. So, it is equal to minus 1 raised to the power Q1 minus 1 by 2 into minus 1 raised to the power Q2 minus 1 by 2 and so on, minus 1 raised to the power Qs minus 1 by 2. Since each one is a power of minus 1, so powers can be added also. So, in the next step, we will just add the powers to get minus 1 raised to the power Q1 minus 1 by 2 plus Q1 2 minus 1 by 2 plus and so on plus Qs minus 1 by 2. Now, the main step starts now. Q1, Q2, the product can be written as 1 plus Q1 minus 1. I am taking it as a number. 1 plus Q2 minus 1, I am taking it as a number. 1, 1 will be cancelled. 1, 1 will be cancelled. So, you will get Q1, Q2. Now, open the brackets. Opening the brackets, you will get 1 into 1 is 1. Plus Q1 minus 1 into 1 is Q1 minus 1. Q2 minus 1 into 1 is plus Q2 minus 1. And plus Q1 minus 1 into Q2 minus 1 can be written as Q1 minus 1 into Q2 minus 1. These two numbers are equal. Since they are equal, they are congruent to each other modulo anything. So I am writing Q1, Q2 is congruent to each other modulo 4. Modulo 4. Look at. This Q1 is odd. So, Q1 minus 1 is even. Q2 is odd. So, Q2 minus 1 is even. The product of two even numbers is always divisible by 4. And we are taking modulo 4. So, anything that is divisible by 4 can be deleted, can be removed. So, this portion can be removed. So, what the result we have got? That Q1, Q2 is congruent to 1 plus Q1 minus 1, 1 by plus Q2 minus 1. This modulo 4 we have got. We can extend this result to 3 numbers, to 4 numbers, and so on. For example, if you extend this to one more number, on the left hand side, you will get Q1, Q2, Q3. On the right side, you will get 1 plus Q1 minus 1 plus Q2 minus 1 plus Q3 minus 1. And similarly, go on extending it up to Qs. So, what you will get on the left hand side, you will get Q1, Q2, Q3, and so on, Qs. Is congruent to 1 plus this, or even this 1 can be taken to the left hand side, you will get minus 1 is congruent to this plus and so on up to plus Qs minus 1 modulo to 4. And this modulo 4 is, you can write 2 into 2. So divide this congruence equation throughout by 2, you will get this divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2, and here also you will get modulo 2. Now, these two numbers are congruent to each other modulo 2. That means either both are even or both are odd. So, minus 1 raised to the power this is same as minus 1 raised to the power this, because either both are even or both are odd. And here you are having minus 1 raised to the power this quantity. So, this is equal to minus 1 raised to the power this quantity. So, in the next step, I am going to write it is equal to minus 1 raised to the power, it is equal to minus 1 raised to the power Q1, Q2, Qs minus 1 by 2. And what is this Q1, Q2, Qs? This is equal to Q. So you get minus 1 raised to the power Q minus 1 by 2. So your minus 1 by Q Jacobi symbol is equal to minus 1 raised to the power Q minus 1 by 2. And similar is the proof for the second part. So, let us see how to prove the second part. The proof is almost similar. A little bit change will be there. So, once again, we will start with let Q is equal to Q1, Q2 and so on. Qs. Now, 2 upon Q. Use the definition of Jacobi symbol and it can be broken into parts 2 by Q1, 2 by Q2 and so on, 2 by Qs. And now each of these, 2 by Q1, 2 by Q2, 2 by Qs, they are Legendre symbols. And Legendre symbol 2 by p, we know that it is equal to minus 1 raised to the power p square minus 1 by 8. So I'm using the definition here. This 2 by q1 will become minus 1 raised to the power q1 square minus 1 by 8. Similarly, the second one will become minus 1 raised to the power q2 square minus 1 by 8. And so on. The last one will become minus 1 raised to the power qs square minus 1 by 8. And since each of these is a power of minus 1, so powers will be added. So what you will get in the next step? This plus this plus this and so on plus this. So powers will be added. So you are on a similar stage as we have just proved. Now we need this step now. Earlier we have started with q1, q2, and now we are going to start with q1 square, q2 square. Q1 square, q2 square can be written as 1 plus q1 square minus 1 into 1 plus q2 square minus 1. So once again, as we have opened the bracket in the previous part, it can be opened as, opening it, you will get 1 plus q1 square minus 1 plus q2 square minus 1 plus q1 square minus 1 into q2 square minus 1. And since these two quantities are equal, they will be congruent to each other modulo anything. So I am taking them congruent to each other modulo 16. Modulo 16. Now, q1 square minus 1. Q1 square minus 1 is q1 minus 1 into q1 plus 1. Q1 is an odd number. Odd minus 1 is even, odd plus 1 is even. So this is even, this is divisible by 4. Because this is divisible by 2, this is divisible by 2. The product is divisible by 4. This product is also divisible by 4. As a whole, this is divisible by 16. And we are working with modulo 16. So any term which is multiple of 16 can be removed. So I am removing this portion because it is divisible by 16. And now divide this both sides throughout by a. And before that, better to take this one to the left hand side. So minus 1 is congruent to this. And divide by 8. So divide by 8. Divide by 8. Divide by 8. And here also modulo 16 will become modulo 2. Once again, these two things are congruent to each other modulo 2. And this can be extended also. So extending this, what you will get? You will get here q1 square, q2 square, qs square minus 1 divided by 8 is q1 square minus 1 by 8, q2 square minus 1 by 8 plus and so on plus qs square minus 1 by 8 modulo 2. Now these two quantities are congruent to each other modulo 2. Once again, that means either both are even or both are odd. So, minus 1 raised to the power of this quantity is same as minus 1 raised to the power of this quantity. And minus 1 raised to the power of this quantity we are having here. So, it can be written as minus 1 raised to the power of this quantity. And what is this? This is your q square. So, it is minus 1 raised to the power q square minus 1 by 8. And this is the required result that we were trying to prove. So, this is another important useful property of Jacobi symbols. And now we are going on to prove Jacobi reciprocity law. As we have proved the quadratic reciprocity law, now we are going to proceed to prove Jacobi's reciprocity law. Jacobi reciprocity law, the proof is almost same as that we have proved here in minus 1 upon q and 2 upon q Jacobi symbols. So I am leaving this part to you. I think you can state and prove Jacobi reciprocity law just reading it from the book and then proceeding. Similarly, as we have proved the last two parts, the previous two parts, you can prove this also. But the result obtained will be the same. That is, q upon p Jacobi symbol is equal to p upon q Jacobi symbol into minus 1 raised to the power p minus 1 by 2 into q minus 1 by 2. This result you will obtain if q is an odd positive integer and p is an integer. So this is Jacobi reciprocity law, and the proof is almost same You can prove it on the same lines as we have proceeded in the previous two properties. So I'm leaving you here. You can solve the questions related to Jacobi reciprocity law at your own, because the procedure is almost similar to that of the questions related to the Legendre's symbol. So here I'm going to end this video and this chapter, quadratic residues, here. In the next video we will meet with some other chapter. Till then, thank you once again.